Hi all. Well, today we're going to talk about how to construct a topology on the real numbers. And this is part of part three of our series on continuity of real valued functions of a real variable. First of all, we're going to answer some questions. What is a topological space? So the set of real numbers and any topology tau on the reals constitutes a topological space. The elements of a topology of the real numbers are open sets of real numbers and their unions and intersections. So you need open sets, and on the real numbers, an open set. An example of an open set on the real numbers is the open interval of all numbers between two numbers A and B. And this set is sometimes written as, we're going to use this notation, the interval A to B, excluding the endpoints A and B. So a topology on the real numbers is going to be sets of this kind for various A's and B's, and unions and intersections of such sets. So there's a lot of sets involved in a topology. And topologies are not unique. There are many topologies possible on the real numbers. The standard topology on the real numbers consists of all epsilon neighborhoods of each point, each number on the real number line. Open interval can be rewritten as a epsilon neighborhood like this. The mean of the two numbers A and B is going to be the center of the epsilon neighborhood, and the value of epsilon is taken to be magnitude of the number B minus A over 2. And so if you write our standard notation n sub epsilon of x0, so it's a set of all numbers in between x0 minus epsilon and x0 plus epsilon, but it excludes the two endpoints. So every open interval of this kind can be expressed in the neighborhood notation. So this is a symmetric neighborhood of the point x naught. Okay. Now, what's an open set? So an open set of real numbers is a set of numbers S such that if x1 is an element of S, then x1 is also a member of an open neighborhood contained in S. So an open set can be viewed as a system of open neighborhoods such that every point in S is contained in an open neighborhood that is itself contained in S. This notation here for n epsilon of x naught is an open neighborhood of the point x naught. So using this definition of an open set, it's easy to prove that open intervals of the sort AB here are open in the real numbers. Okay, so we have open sets, open neighborhoods defined. Okay, what's a topology? Well, a topology is a system of sets. It is itself a set. So a topology is a set that contains the real numbers and the empty set, and it also contains a bunch of other sets, or you could just stop with these two entries and have what's called the trivial topology on the real numbers. So there are going to be a bunch of other sets here constituting the topology in general. Each of the elements of the topology is an open set. Okay. Now, one of the reasons that the concept of continuity of functions on the real numbers is kind of slippery is that it really turns out that it is only open neighborhoods of real numbers that support continuity of functions. And so if you just focus on real numbers and the elements of the set R, it makes the definition of continuity rather awkward and a little bit hard to grasp. So the reason we introduce topologies on the real numbers provide a more powerful and intuitive way of defining continuity. But it turns out that topology tau is more useful than the set of real numbers when we need to construct and verify that we have continuous functions on the reals. Okay, one way of thinking of a topology is you imagine all possible open sets on the real numbers. That includes sets that are disjoint. You know, you can have an open set over here, an open interval, and here's another one, and here's a third. These are individually open sets, but we also require that the union of these sets be included in the topology. So you have this open set that consists of these three disjoint neighborhoods. Okay, so we need the rules for a topology. Let's define topology. The topology is sometimes called a system of sets, that is, it's a set whose elements are open sets. If A and B are in tau, then the union of A and B is in tau. The intersection of A and B is an element of tau. Tau also has to contain the set of real numbers and the empty set. Okay. So if you have a collection of subsets of the real numbers and you want to know if it's a topology, you take the unions of them two by two and confirm that every union gives you another element of tau. And you do the same thing for intersections pairwise, and if that's in tau, and if the real numbers themselves and the empty set are contained in tau, then tau is a topology. Okay. So what do we have our questions numbered here? So we had our first question up here, what's a topological space? Here, what's an open set? Question 3, what's a topology? And question 4, how do I construct a topology on R? Okay, well, there's a kind of an iterative recipe for doing this, and it's very simple, and you get a lot of freedom. Step 1 in generating a topology on R is to pick out some collection of open sets, call them sub alpha, just a bunch of open sets indexed by alpha, And this is going to be the basis of the topology that we're creating. So this A alpha is the collection of open sets we start with, and now we're going to start calculating stuff from them. So step two is to take your A's and go through and calculate all possible unions and intersections of pairs of the A's. And when you do this, you'll probably generate some new sets. What we're going to do is take those new sets and add them to a collection of sets that include the A's. So we combine the sets generated in step two with the sets we started with in one to get a new system of sets. Call it B alpha. So we started with just the A's. Now we have the B's, which include the A's up here, and they also include new sets that we calculated in step two. So we include all of the sets that we had in one and two, and we combine them together and get this new set, this new system of sets. These are, each of the B's is an open set, and the collection of open sets is called a system of sets. So the B's constitute a new system of sets. Okay, now we have this collection of B's. We simply go back and repeat step two with the B's. So we calculate all unions and intersections of the B's, and they may generate some new sets or they might not. So if they generate new sets, you combine the new ones with all the old ones you had in B, and then repeat the process with a new set, with a new system of sets, you know, C alpha, D alpha, and so on. Now eventually you're going to kind of run out of new sets, and you have constructed all possible unions and intersections of all the sets that you can possibly get from the basis. So we're going to call this set as sort of a convergence. We're going to call this set that you get at the end of this W, and the elements of W, the open sets of the system of sets W, are going to be W alpha. After we're finished iterating all these union intersections, we take the set W and combine it with the set of real numbers and the empty set, if they didn't already exist within W, and construct this system of sets tau, consisting of the W's, the empty set, and the reals. And tau is a topology. The way we constructed tau is it guarantees it to be a topology, because tau now contains all unions and intersections of its members. And this topology tau is the topology generated by the basis A alpha. So if you picked a different basis, you might get a different topology, you might get the same one. So this is sort of a computer programmer's outline of some kind of computer program, or you can do this conceptually, abstractly, and in this way generate lots of different topologies on the set of real numbers. Let's take a look at some simple examples. Two sets. Let's do the symmetric interval minus 1 to 1 and call that A. The interval between 2 and 3, call that B. Okay, so you take these two sets along with the real numbers and the empty set, and you put these in a box. So you have real number and the empty set, A and B. We're going to calculate the intersection of A and B. Well, that's the empty set. These intervals do not overlap. And that empty set is already in our box. So this intersection didn't generate any new ones. If you take the intersection of A with the real numbers, you get A. Same thing with B. So the intersection doesn't generate anything new. What about the union? Well, A union B is interesting. So this set has A union B is a new one. It's a disjoint pair of intervals. So you had the set A, which is this interval right here, and we have the set B, this interval over here, and the union of those two is the whole thing there, and it's a couple of disjoint sets. So we're going to call this thing here C, and C is distinct from both elements A and B. And of course, if you take unions or intersections of the set C with any of the others in the box, we're going to put C in the box down here. Intersections and unions of these taken two at a time generates sets that we already have in the box. So that means that this thing here is a topology. It's kind of a measly topology, and it has how many elements? Well, it has, you could say it consists of five different open sets, five distinct open sets. The cardinality of each of these sets, let's take a look at that. The cardinality of the real numbers is the uncountable infinity, sometimes called aleph 1. Cardinality of the empty set is 0. And look at this, the cardinality of this, all these sets A, B, and C is also the cardinality of the real numbers. They're open intervals on the real number line, and the cardinality of an open interval is the same as the entire real number. So it's uncountable infinity of numbers in each of the sets A, B, and C. Let's take a look at another instance of a topology. Euclidean description of drawing a continuous line. You start at a point over here, end up at some point over here like this. Now, notice that as we draw the line, we're actually creating a whole collection of open intervals. If you stop at any point on this drawing, you get a line segment that's shorter than the line segment AB. Here, this is sort of a rigorous way of looking at drawing the line, have actually generated a whole collection of open intervals. You can write this collection of open intervals as AX, where X is an element of the interval AB. Okay? So look at this. We have a system of sets, AX. Well, we have this system of open sets. So why don't we see if we can construct a topology using this as the basis for our topology. We can pick anything we want as a basis, any collection of open sets. So let's pick this collection. Notice that each of these segments here is contained in the segments below it and not contained in the segments above it. So let's pick out a few points along the way. Here's x1, x2, and so on, x3. So we're stopping at different x's along the way to getting to x equals b. So AX1 union AX2. Well, here's X2 over here, and here is X1. So the interval with X1 in it, the interval between A and X1 is contained in the interval between A and X2. So this thing, this union, is equal to AX2. So the union of any pair of these intervals gives you the larger of the two intervals. What about intersections? Okay, so since x2 is greater than x1, the intersection of these two line segments is going to be the points in common, which is the interval, the shorter of the two intervals, a, x, 1. But those two sets that we generated by taking the union and intersection are already contained in our basis. So notice that by taking unions, we do not generate any disjoint intervals. We just get back the larger of the two intervals. So that means that our basis constructed this way is a topology. So the topology we get this way, and I'll call this topology AB. So it's the topology on the open interval A to B, and it consists of these open intervals. So it's a set of open intervals of the form AX, where X is between A and B. And that is a topology here, open intervals of the form. And then, okay, we forgot, we've got to add in, define the topology tau AB this way of these open intervals combined with the whole real numbers and the empty set. We have a topology on the real numbers. This topology is called a weak topology. Go back here to this line segment A to B, and don't stop with just these open intervals, but instead collect this set of all open neighborhoods on A and B. You know, then you get topology AB, but you also get new sets, and that is the that would be a stronger topology. So a topology is stronger if it contains the weaker topology. So if you have some topology that is generated by a different basis, and if that topology contains the topology tau AB, then tau is stronger, and tau AB is weaker. So you may have heard of this term of strong topologies and weak topologies. Weak topologies are not always bad. They can be very useful. You can support the notion of weak convergence, and it has some important implications in the theory of differential equations. Can be useful.
Okay, now.
So I think that's a good place to stop our chat. I hope you enjoyed this discussion of elementary topology of the real numbers and the concept of a topological basis. I think we've answered some questions and made some important definitions.